Welcome to my channel, my dear friends. Today I am going to show you how to make this beautiful and very easy puff stitch. You can see this is a V puff stitch and this is very easy and it's really for beginners level. They can really make it anything, and this I have demonstrated in a flat piece. If you are making a round piece also, that is also possible for the V stitch. And I have used here this super saver knitting yarn. You can say it's a 8-ply yarn, and it's a bit thick yarn. Here they have instructed to use 4.5 mm hook, but I have used here, you can see, 3.5 mm hook size. So I like to work in that hook size, and it's coming very nice. This is the front and this is the back of this V stitch. It looks almost same from both the sides, and we have made a base foundation chain for this, and then we have worked this puff stitches. So when you are working, you have to work in the multiples of 4 plus 1 chain as a turning chain of your this V stitch. So before rolling into the video, please like my video, and if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel so that you can get more easy and simple videos from which you can learn many new things. And I would really like to know what you have made by using this stitch, what all projects you are going to make by using this stitch. So please comment it in the comment section. So let's start the video. So first we will make a slip stitch. And for this stitch, first we are going to make a foundation row. So now we are going to work multiples of 4. So I am going to work 28, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So same, you have to work multiple of 4. So I will be working 28 chains. So after working multiples of 4, I have made, it is just a demonstration piece, so I have worked 28 chain and chain of 1 as a turning chain. And then whatever it is, we are going to work in every single chain, we are going to work a single crochet. It's up to you. It's a foundation chain, so you can work half double crochet also or double crochet also. So I'm going to work a single crochet. That's why for single crochet I have used 1 chain. If you are working half double crochet, you have to use 2 chains as a turning chain, and if you are working a double crochet, then you have to use 3 chains. So now in every stitch, you can see in every stitch we are going to make a single crochet. So same, you have to work a single crochet in all the stitches. This is the way which we are going to work. In all the stitches, we will work a single crochet for our foundation chain. So you can see we have completed this our single crochet, and now at the end we are going to make here chain of 2, and then we will turn our work. So after turning our work, what we have to do, we are going to skip 3 single crochet. First one we won't count, 1, 2, and 3 we'll skip, and in the fourth, you see, first one we are not counting, 1, 2, 3, and in the fourth chain we have to work, take both, and we have to just pull it through. We have to yarn over and pull it tight, you can see. Just like this, we have to keep it like this. Then again, we'll put yarn over and pull it through. So this is 2 times. Then again, yarn over, put it and pull it through. This is four, sorry, third time, and then last yarn over, pull it through, put it and pull it through. So this is four times. So you see, four times we have did it. Now what we are going to do, we are going to yarn over and pull the hook from all these loops, and from the first one also. So our first puff is created, and then chain one to join this all, and then again chain of one as a chain one space. Then again in the same chain itself, again we are going to do the same, we are going to repeat this four times. So pull through one, pull to two, pull through three, and then pull through four. So you see, then again we will put it and pull this very slowly from all the loops and pass, and then chain one as a locking chain. After this, you see our first puff is ready. After this, what we are going to do, again we are going to skip 1, 2 and 3, 1, 2, 3, and again in the fourth one we will take both the chains, and in the fourth chain again we will repeat the same process. We have to just pull through it. 1, sorry, see, this is, I'm using a 8-ply yarn. If you are using a less, this is a thick chunky kind of yarn. So if you are using a thin yarn, you can use more number of pull throughs. So it's 2, 3 and 4. So now we have to pass it from all the loops, you see, then lock it, then chain of one, and then again we will, in the same stitch itself, we have to do this same pull through again. 1, 2, 3 and 4, and then we will lock it. That's it. So this is the pattern. You can see it's coming out really nice. Our V puff stitch we can see. So I will meet you at the last and tell you how to turn from there. So we have reached our last. You can see our V puff stitches already coming out. It's a first row. So last one, what we have to do, we are going to work a double crochet at the last chain. Now again we are going to have chain of 2, 1, 2, turn our work, and as you can see, now we will repeat the same thing. Just now we are going to work in between of our puff stitches, same process we are going to repeat in between of our puff stitch. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So four times we are now having pull through, and then we will pull it from all the loops. You can see. And then chain one to close it, and then again chain one as a chain one space, and again in the same space we are going to again do the same pull through. 1 2 3 and 4. So this again we are going to pull through chain one. So you see how our work is going to come. So now you can see a perfect V puff shape. Now again same, we are going to repeat it all the way along. Same, we will have this pull throughs. Just remember, the puff one, sometime it always depends upon the type of thread you are using and your ply, how many plies you are using. Normally when you need more puff, you can use even 5 times pull through also, or if you want very less puff, you can use 3 also. So this is my 8 ply yarn, that is why I am using only 4 times pull through. So it depends upon you. So same way you have to again do it, pull through 1. When you are doing it first, it will be a bit tight for you, but eventually when you start doing it, you will be used to it. So you see how it has come. So this is the same pattern which we are going to work all the way along, and in the end again we are going to make a double crochet and chain of 2 and turn our work, and again in between same pattern we have to work all the way along. So if you like my pattern, if you like this stitch, please subscribe to my channel, like my video, and if possible give it a share, and don't forget to press the notification button near your subscribe button so that you will be notified for all my upcoming videos. And do look for new upcoming videos. Thank you.